they don't want you to know this information. And in fact, this is the second book we've written. The first one was called Plague, and this is about the, you know, literally about our groundbreaking discoveries of mouse cancer causing viruses, the publication in a journal, Science. And when it became clear that of the number of strains of these mouse cancer-causing and neuroimmune disease-causing viruses that had entered the human virome by way of a contaminated blood supply and contaminated vaccines with lots of animal tissues and lots of different viruses, they needed to shut this down, because of course this is exactly what happened, what is, you know, COVID-19, a coronavirus that entered the human virome in a way that wasn't natural, that is not a natural evolution of a virus that's being sold as anything but. So when the data became clear that this virus was in the human virome by a contaminated blood supply that could have been contaminated for 30 years, 25 times more people were infected than in HIV AIDS at the height of HIV in this country in 1991. So as the data emerged that also that likely these mouse viruses got into humans by way of contaminated vaccines, then of course the hammer began to fall where publications were published, and I was told to deny the data, to misrepresent the data, to throw the data away. And when I refused to do so, I was fired. My lab was locked down on September 29th, and two offices and my entire 30-year career and everything, my notebooks, everything was confiscated. Then I'm arrested at the door with no warrant, as I'm surrounded by police cars. My house is, the water has the Harbor Patrol in it. There's no warrant. My husband's pushed into a chair. They search my entire house. They take me away in foot shackles and hand shackles in front of the entire neighborhood, who all said they knew something was going on because of the amount of, you know, force that was used. I was held in jail for 5 days in Ventura County without bail, on a bail hold without the possibility, never saw a judge, never saw a lawyer. And the charges that were reported in the journal Science on November 19, 2011 in Science Insider by John Cohen, C-O-H-E-N, was that nobody filed the warrant. Meaning not Ventura County, not Sparks, not Reno, where the institute, my employers were, not Washoe County. And the only thing they could conclude was that these felony charges for fugitive from justice had to come from one of several federal agencies. So I'm held on felony charges of a fugitive from justice, and I don't so much as have a parking ticket. You have to base a charge like that on something. It was based on nothing. NIH, the NIH and the National Cancer Institute in Frederick, Maryland, they still say I'm a fugitive from justice, or did the last time I was there, which was November 15, 2016, when I went to go to Fort Detrick to the laboratories where I worked for 22 years, you know, literally my last job was as the director of the internationally acclaimed Lab of Antiviral Drug Mechanisms, where we made drugs for AIDS-associated cancers and did much pioneering research in the 2 years there when I developed that lab. When the study was unblinded, there was a very super secret phone call, a conference call with Tony Fauci, Francis Collins, and Harold Varmus. And during this super secret conference call, we were all told there was no association. And this was after we were told every study center was equally represented. We know that he stopped the study and we would have found more than 80% positive. And I said, during that phone call, I said, that's okay. 6% is still 25 million Americans at that time. Our table 3 of the study that was published in September and October in MBio is the journal. It's called MBio by Ian Lipkin. The abstract of the paper said there was no evidence of XMRVs found by any group. Clearly, on table 3 of that paper, there was 6.1% in the patients and 6.1% in the controls. So yes, there was no association, but we still, every single study that was ever done showed between 4 and 7.8% of the American, of the U.S. population was infected, were asymptomatic carriers, if you were, and some very, very ill with many, many cancers.